Hi, I'm Tim Wolkman, Watchbox, and thanks for logging on. If you love this watch, and I do, reach out to me, tmosso@thewatchbox.com. It's in the description below. Your purchase and pricing email question line for buying this or any watch you see on any Watchbox platform. Reach out to me directly, email tmosso@thewatchbox.com. Oh my goodness, this is going to be a good day at the office. Launched for 2021 in 10 pieces in grade 5 titanium, this is the De Béthun DB kind of 2 Tourbillon. A watch that can do this. Two sides with correctly geared hands to run clockwise regardless of which side you are viewing. So we have a watch that is grade 5 titanium, meaning it's the kind you can polish, more scratch resistant than steel, but also lighter than steel. 42.8 millimeters in diameter, but somehow only 12.2 millimeters thick. It's about as thick as a Rolex Daytona. It uses the new De Béthun intermediate size variable geometry floating lugs. So these actually adjust between 49.3 millimeters at their narrowest to 52.2 is their broadest, and then 26 millimeters is the spacing between the lugs. Again, there are only 10 of these for 2021. It is a very special watch. Because of the floating lug system, first launched on the DB26 perpetual calendar, we have variable geometry on the wrist and a watch that wears beautifully on my 16 centimeter circumference wrist. It will conform to you. There are several different lug sizes available from the factory, so if you ever send it back for a service and you want a bigger lug or a smaller lug, they can put that in there. Being as low as it is, although it's large and sporty, it will work as a dress watch with its sloped case flank and its low profile. You can see, the further I move away from the camera, the better it looks proportionally. Don't think of it as an oversized watch. Think of it as about a full-size watch. It wears like a 40 millimeter watch in steel. Really gorgeous. Taking a quick look at the hardware and the software, this is elementary, but I do love to focus on details. Here we have a black, large rectangular scale alligator leather strap with a semi-gloss finish, closer to matte even than gloss, and you can see that it has a monotone stitch with a sheer cut profile showing the layers of leather. And of course, this is upscale. This is what high horology is all about, getting alligator leather on both sides of the strap for long wearing durability. The strap has a little bit of a tapered profile, and you can see round scales used on the bottom, rectangular scale on the top. A lovely pin buckle. As you can see, it features a little bit of evacuation in its profile to remind you of the structure of the floating lugs themselves. And of course, it too is made by De Béthun. This company, as with F.P. Journe and other top independents, makes its cases, its dials, and its movements in-house. So this is a manufactured product inside and out from a company that only makes 150 watches a year, and since its inception in 2002 has only made just under 3,000 pieces total, so rarity is assured. In 2011, the DB28 using the spring-loaded lug system won the GPHG Aiguille d'Or, or the overall prize at the Oscars of watchmaking, and you can see the lug profile is open and airy. The end of the lug features this little ogival rocket cap or torpedo-shaped end that reminds us of the earliest De Béthun timepieces of the early to mid-2000s, but everything else is forward-looking. As we move inboard, you can see the case is traditionally round, and it has a anti-bullhead crown. So the bullhead would be at the top, and if we had a crown up there, we would call it a bullhead winder. This one, of course, is fixed at the base of the watch, and the idea is that you will retract the lug, and then you will wind and set the watch. I should mention, this movement has a feature I've never seen on a De Béthun timepiece, and that is hacking or stop seconds. So that's a new innovation introduced here. Manual wind, 5-day power reserve. The dial is their own, of course, and it's real rose lathe guilloche. They have their own guilloche. They have their own rose lathe engine. So this dial is cut in-house, but it's not open and extravagant like the DB28s, for example. Some people are put off by the avant-garde, almost Starfleet-like futuristic appearance of the DB28. This is much more traditional and accessible to that kind of audience. At center, we have hands made of grade 5 titanium that have been fired and oxidized, this bewitching metallic blue, and De Béthun has a patent for that bluing process. If you've ever seen oxidized titanium, you know that it's white, not blue, so getting it to do this is very difficult. All the printing on the dial is blue on silver, for a handsome and warm contrast. And then you can see outboard, you can read your seconds and minutes. And when we flip the dial over, there's a cam system that locks the watch into place on each side. So it pops into place and there's no play or desire to rotate once each side is selected. Now on the reverse side, you can see everything that appears to be hand finished with black polish truly is. We have what De Béthun calls their deltoid style barrel bridge, 3 points. So like a triangle, or as some have said, a Starfleet badge from Star Trek, you can see there are are tiered chevrons at each corner, which enhance the aesthetic. And you can see that the center of the barrel bridge has a tiered profile, which is gorgeous, sort of like a pagoda or the steps of a pyramid. The same treatment has been rendered on the outside of the tourbillon carriage. There's a sort of cylinder in which it sits. So all of this has been finished off with diamond paste to give it that specular or black polish. Most high-end watches will be content to simply give you black polished screws or maybe a swan's neck regulator. With De Baytoun, you get acres of it. There's a chaptering outboard against which you can read the minutes. And note, we have a set of hour and minute hands here. And then we have a tourbillon, which is not the seconds hand for this dial, as the tourbillon actually moves at 30 seconds per sweep. So its period is 30 seconds. It moves twice the speed of a standard wristwatch 1 minute tourbillon. It also beats away at 36,000 vibrations per hour like a Zenith El Primero. The tourbillon carriage, the entire assembly really, only weighs 0.18 gram and it is a combination of silicon and titanium with white gold balance masses. It is the lightest tourbillon cage in existence, and it helps this watch to achieve a precision of plus or minus 1 second per day. With the twin self-adjusting barrels, again, you get that 5-day manual wind power reserve. I should mention there is a lot that is patented in this watch. The floating lugs are patented. Twin self-adjusting barrels, patented. The process for fire-bluing titanium, patented. The balance made of titanium and fire-blued with white gold masses, that's patented. The hairspring shaped by hand with two flat elements clamped together, that's patented. And the advantage is that it beats concentrically like an overcoil, but with the shock, resistance, and thin profile of a flat hairspring. And then there is a silicon escapement to reduce friction, that too is patented. Everything about this watch is exceptional. Everything about this watch goes over and above. This is what dreams are made of, and it is the definition of a Grail watch. All of this 30 meters water resistant. You can see that De Baytoun uses mirrored anglage on certain profile surfaces. It fire blues the cabochon that represent the hour markers here. We have media blasting within the hollows of the hour track, and then a micro light engraving on the center bridge, and that is a sort of reductive guilloche that is unique to De Baytoun. It is simply dripping with artistry and avant-garde engineering. Reach out to Team also at thewatchbox.com for purchase and pricing details.